celebration with us. Something new. to the Professional Women's Rodeo Association as a result of walking with God and finding out he wanted to be involved with people in life, not simply in the church services. In 1986, she was offered the opportunity to ride a bull for the crowning of Miss Rodeo America at the National Finals Rodeo in Las Vegas, Nevada. As a result, opportunities for her ministry began to open up at rodeos and other Western events across this great country. She has now been traveling all across the United States for almost 30 years. She's a singer, songwriter with 9 recordings today. She writes monthly articles in several horse and rodeo-related magazines, plus a TV program on God's Learning Channel called Cowgirl Logic. She has 2 sons, Tiger Tuff. He's a West Point graduate who is a major in the U.S. Army, a coat wrangler who builds motorcycles, rides ranch broncs, fights bulls, and is a drummer in a Texas band. Ladies and gentlemen, she still travels with her horse and other animals to events nationwide. Her horse, by the way, just happens to be an amazing Gypsy Vanner horse stallion known as Trider. The Gypsy Vanner Cobb Horse Foundation is honored to have Crystal and Strider help us celebrate this milestone year. Ladies and gentlemen, Crystal Lyon.
Thank y'all. I thought he was just going to say, this is Crystal Lyons and Strider. I wasn't expecting that. It is so good to have y'all here. Thank y'all so much for coming. I hope you thoroughly enjoy these amazing animals. They're wonderful, they're beautiful, and they're super smart. And God bless y'all, and we are about to start. Ready? Yeah. Oh, you know, I gotta stay in here. Pay my attention. I wrote this song 10 years ago. I love this country. For all the folks in this world, I
on the catwalk. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem to follow, to be presented by Crystal. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us to be a part of this historic equestrian event. And dear Lord, without you, it would not have been possible for such an undertaking to take place. And Lord, we are dedicating this to those who have fought and died as well as come home wounded, and that we may enjoy our freedom to be here tonight. We ask that you wrap your arms around the families of those who have gone before us and those that are still feeling the effects of guaranteeing our safety in this great country, all guided by you. Father, we take this time to thank you for the many blessings bestowed upon each and every one of us, and ask that you forgive us for ways we have failed thee. But most of all, dear Lord, thanks for the gift of your Son, who died for us, so that we may have everlasting life for the belief in him. I ask that you watch over each and every individual and family here tonight. Once they depart, lead, guide, and direct us, and have us go in the way that you want. In your heavenly name we pray. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, our Pledge of Allegiance. Our youngsters.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, still the number one song in all the world, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our kids, that they don't have that in them. And I believe God is going to do some awesome things in this country. He's not through with America, y'all. He's not.
We the people of the United States, in order to form form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity. Do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
Thank you for your service.
this song years ago, and it's what I want to say to you. Everything that we do, the horses, rodeo, everything, it's because somebody paid a price for our freedom. And you guys are my heroes. You're my heroes.
Yeah, back it up.
I don't know where that was starting at.
Beckons all to come and feast upon its bounty.
designed to transport artillery pieces and ammunition, and together they've long been used to carry caskets for military funerals. Caissons are used to bear the caskets of the deceased in some state military funerals. And in certain Western cultures, including the United States and United Kingdom, horses or other draft animals were harnessed in single file to haul the limber, which is attached to the caisson. Now, the British developed this system of carriages, which was adopted by the French and then copied from the French by the United States. This caisson and limber is a replica from the Civil War era built by Amish craftsmen in Pennsylvania at a cost of $13,000. Now notice a special harness collar also. Deborah Gray, the owner, said they will not charge the families of the veterans it is used for, but they will gladly accept donations. Deborah Gray, she's the owner of Tranquility Country Farm in Memphis, Florida. She's a 501c3 organization that's been helping people and veterans overcome hardship by bringing them to her home farm and experiencing the love and compassion of a horse and other farm animals that can bring to your life. Now, Deborah has spina bifida, and is a condition that affects the spine and is usually apparent at birth. It's a type of neural tube defect. Spina bifida, now it can happen anywhere along the spine if the neural tube does not close all the way. And in 2017, Deborah's husband left unexpectedly, leaving her to care for the farm and animals by herself. Later that year, Hurricane Irma hit, destroying most of the property and completely destroyed her home. And even with all that going on in her life, Deborah still puts everyone else first. If anyone is ever in need of help, she is always there. She donates her time and the use of her black Gypsy Vanner and her personal caisson to the Cape Canaveral National Cemetery for veterans to have a wonderful service that they deserve, and she never charges for it. Her passion is helping the veterans. She has a Gypsy Vanner horses, chickens, goats, cats, and ducks on her property for anyone to come and enjoy. Deborah is truly a wonderful woman that will give you the shirt off of her back if you're in need. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for Deborah Gray and her Gypsy Vanner and our peace on here tonight.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, Denver Gray and Arkansas. We need our spotters in the arena, please, as well as the barriers closed up. Thank you. Crystal?
All right, y'all, hiya. We're going to do something here that's, it's typical. It's either going to be really cool or I'm going to bomb out, okay? So either way, y'all act like it was cool no matter what. All right? He is, my stallion here, he thinks when he showed up here that he was coming to breed mares, and he still has that opinion. And, he's thinking everything over yonder is lined up. Dear Lord, there's some things he'd breed a cow. I mean, whatever. So, anyway, but I wanted to show something about freedom. People can say, well, so, what? Oh, did you come to carry my saddle, didn't you? Oh, son, go ahead and pull that up. Here you go. And the thing is he's going to go right over there. And that fence is really low. But let's just see how this works. He's going to go smell poop, but there ain't much poop in here but his own. Yeah. All right. So this is the deal. It's like, just like my horse there.
You worn him out, Crystal.
Yeah. So, we think when we're free and we're just loose to do what we want, no plan except mares. Yeah, keep him off of that fence, y'all. So the thing is that we end up not having any purpose in life. We just run around and cause chaos. Yeah, don't lift the whip. That's his cue to rear. You're cueing him to rear. Y'all need to be inside the pen and slap his legs, but then you might get kicked. See, if you lift him. So anyway, well, I'll probably have to go over there. All right. Yeah, I'm telling you. He's got female on the brain, all right? So, the thing is I own this horse. My name is on his papers. Yep. He's my horse. But let me ask you this. Is he paying any attention to me at all right now? Oh, y'all are so smart. No, he's not paying any attention to me right now. Here. Hey. There you go. Come here, buddy. Come here. Now I didn't bring my bridle. It's over yonder because I was expecting to. Wayne, I'm going to run you tonight a lot. You want to run over there and get my bridle for me, please? Run hard. Run fast. It's on the beanbag. Because I'm not going to let him go back to that right there. Okay, so the Bible says in Amos 3:3, how can two walk together except they be agreed? Me and this horse, even though I own him, was he walking with me a while ago? No, obviously not. He had his own plan. And that's the way it goes. A lot of times when what we call freedom is I'm on my own, do my own thing. What is going on here? Is there something kinked? No, yeah, let go and let me feel this. There we go. Thank you. All right. All this hair. Why did we pay so much money for all this hair?
He's just a man with a mind of his own, huh?
What did he say? Okay, here we go. You can take that whip now. All right. So, the thing is even though I own him, he's walking around with no purpose. He's just gonna roll, smell the poop, chase women, get in trouble, cause chaos, and all of that. Until this horse, by himself, will never find his full potential. Not until God put him and me together. And then when God put him and me together, all of a sudden this horse is not just loose and bored in a pen, but we're going places and he's getting to have adventures. He loves to work cattle. He drags bulls out of rodeo arenas and stuff. He's a cool horse. But you know what? Until he submits to me, we can't work together. Now let me tell you something. White girl here can't jump. Come on. You did it once on your own here. He goes, yeah, but that was my idea. Yeah, let's find the perfect little spot where you can lay down. Give me a break, buddy. Hey, come back to me. There you go. Come on. There you go. There you go, sweet pea. Yes. Oh, gosh. Yes. Unless he submits to me, he works for food, y'all. Okay, the thing is, until he comes under leadership, he's just a loose horse. Just a loose horse with no purpose. But when he surrenders to who was created to be over him, then all things begin to work and we can start doing stuff. We just learned this a while ago. It ain't me. I mean, I love that right there. Is that not cool? I love that. And we can start doing something and have purpose in life. Everything has purpose. Everyone has purpose. And every nation has purpose. But until we surrender to the one who is to be over us, when we create a void in our country and take God out, then what do we expect? But evil will fill that void unless people begin to start standing up, get back into places that you're supposed to be, and let God begin to have control of this nation again. No. That was failure. Oh, this is pitiful. Okay. You're being a fart. No, do not clap. He'll go, see, it was good enough for them. But until we surrender to the one that was supposed to be united, when you come under who you're supposed to be under, then there's true freedom. He has all kinds of adventures and everything else. And it's the same way with us. We can say we're free, but we're just out rolling around in the dirt and smelling poop. And God wants to cause us to come in with Him and have an adventure with Him. And it's the same way with the nation. When our nation comes back under the one who created her, we will have greater days in the future and wonderful times together. And I'm telling you, I know this for a fact. God's got great things for America. God bless you guys, and thank you so much for being so kind. Yeah, because I ain't jumping that bareback. Thank you.
And of course, we're going to go to the Jumbotron, ladies and gentlemen, for a special word by Greg Davis. Makes his home in Lockwell, California. And of course, he's got a special message for us. All eyes at the Jumbotron.
The staff of the Making Pegasus Project would like to congratulate the many people who recognized the exquisite uniqueness of the Gypsy Manor Horse, who loved and cared for this breed, and have worked to encourage its excellence over the last 25 years. The Making Pegasus Project incorporates the Gypsy Vanner with 12 other breeds in its quest to create the greatest horse in the world because of its size, feather, mane, tail, intelligence, temperament, and genetic depth. The creation of the greatest horse in the world is no small ambition. A horse of jaw-dropping size, elite athleticism in terms of strength, speed, endurance, agility, and grace, and all the elements of beauty, actually becomes a grand metaphor for the deliberate creation of the ultimate life. Liberty is the right to create your experience in existence as you wish, subject only to the equal rights of others. The Making Pegasus Project exists to create the ultimate horse, but to fund and participate in the expansion of the envelope of research into equine understanding, especially equine genetics. Making Pegasus, in collaboration with UC Davis, has fully sequenced 80 of its horses, including 8 Gypsy Vanners, doubling the equine genome library of UC Davis. These fully sequenced genomes and numerous future genomes of the Making Pegasus offspring will serve as the foundation that will permit genetic inquiry and understanding of the genes involved in heretofore mysteries. The Making Pegasus herd currently has several master's theses, studies, and PhD dissertations underway to determine the genes responsible for feathering, chronic progressive lymphedema, equine autism, and eye coloring.
We're going to have a little dance contest. Crystal's got something we call redneck rap, huh? Is that right?
Yeah, unless he's got medley. If he's got medley, do y'all remember Linda Ronstadt?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Can you get medley? Can you pull it up?
You want the medley?
I want medley, and then we'll do redneck rap, because I
should know what we're going to do the medley.
Anyway, y'all remember Linda Ronstadt? Remember that song, Blue Bayou? That was just the coolest song. Well, I got my own version, and it's totally screwed it up, but I like it, so I'm going to sing you this medley if he can go back and find it, because I was supposed to have done it before I rode out of the arena. So, if you got it, punch it. If you don't, you're going to have to listen. There we go. Thank you, guys. You're awesome. All right. Here's my version. Can you give me a little more track?
Hanging out with some of my friends, telling jokes and laughing with them. Had to tell it over again, 'cause it blew by you. Everyone was all in the flow, expecting that you would know, but your clueless expression did show that it blew by you. You're so cute, you know, but you're kind of slow. If we could only see some light in your eyes that show you happy we'd be. But your color is true, you're blonde through and through, and it blew by you.
Right? just great. We're going to have us a little bit of a dance contest. We're going to get into this other song and just, we want you guys to get involved, kids, get involved.
I am on the mic.
I was calling you.
I couldn't hear you.
My mic wasn't working.
Oh.
I said, are we doing that redneck rap?
Yep, right now.
Oh my God, we're doing redneck rap. Hey you guys, let's see you stand up. You know, I never did get this. Is this how you do it? You know, with the redneck rap kind of thing going on. I want to see these fingers.
Quiet. We want the right fingers, y'all.
The fingers. We want to see fingers, okay?
Just
now,
fingers.
Now, there's a lot riding on this line here. So, y'all girls out there, you want to do some redneck rapping? Come on in. Now, somebody needs to get, like, really going here. Like, we need some people out here doing the things, the head nods, the fist pump. Yep, there you go. I don't really know what that means. If somebody can explain it, I'd like to know. But anyway, is that what it is? Okay. Sorry, Sarah, Crystal.
Sarah, can I, your cap? Can I borrow your cap? All right, cool. You don't have headlights, do you? just making sure. Thank you, sir. I have headlights. It don't fit me. We gonna have to do some adjusting here. Okay, you're so forgiving. While I was raising the boys and we was taking them to rodeos and stuff, when you go home and you've got kids, you know, you pick up other kids and they're getting in the back of the truck and they're entertaining themselves. And boys, they ain't got a lot of lyrics, they got sounds. So they're back there, and they started making up rap songs. Well, y'all, I'm not crazy about rap anyway, but white boys can rarely rap. White cowboys definitely can't rap. And so I'm driving, and being the cool mom that I am, I know they're going to run out of lyrics pretty soon. So I'm thinking up my own lyrics, you know, and sure enough, they run out of steam, and I went into this song and made up my own deal while they were boom chicka booming. And when it got done, all the boys was laughing. And when we got home, my boys said, "Mother, don't ever do that again." But you know what? They're grown, and I can do what I want. And so about 10 years after that, I still remember these stupid lyrics. So I put it on a song, on an album. And y'all got hog problems down here, don't you? Yeah, maybe not in concrete land, but you go. Okay, I gotta have this cap on or I can't rap, but I am Tim. This is a talent, a hidden talent of mine that my boys wish would stay in. Go ahead. Come on.
Yeah, I got everything together, everything loaded up.
Pretend I can die and I keep it, not a gun sound here, there ain't no I wrote about his eyes and called it redneck rap.
Yes, indeed. I'll tell you what, what fun that was, huh? I think our rap dancers in the middle of the arena kind of look like some chickens on X-Lax, huh? But that's okay, they got through. Let's give them a round of applause, if you would, huh? Thank you, Crystal. Awesome job. Yes, indeed. And, of course, more Gypsy Vanners to come. And we're going to have school in session in just a little while. But I want to introduce you to Nancy Leonard and Toffee. And they'll be making their way in momentarily. Nancy will be driving Toffee around the arena, and I will tell you something about them as well. All right, Nancy. I think we're going to be ready for you in just a moment. Once we give Crystal a little break, she takes a little time out there. Crystal, we do appreciate you. There you go, putting on her cowgirl gear. All right. You know, in 2015, Nancy Leonard moved with her family and nine Gypsy Vanners from Belgium to Florida, ladies and gentlemen. And one of which was a stallion, Toffee, Rock, a pointy ranch born in England. And in June of 2009 is when they moved. And of course, the horse was born in England. And in the Netherlands, he became a champion in the arena and areas of confirmation and undersaddle recognized by the Irish Cow Society of the Netherlands. Now, less than a year after arriving stateside, Toffee's show career began. He received Grand Champion Awards in halter, English, Western, jumping, and driving. And of course, Toffee is mighty. Loved by this family, and Nancy says he's a stallion with a golden character and a good work ethic that shows in his offspring. And the Gypsy Vanner Cobb Horse Foundation is honored to have Toffee and Nancy join us for our silver celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, they're driving a modern carriage. Let's give them a round of applause, if you would. Nancy Vanner. Thank you, Nancy, and job well done. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to focus your attention to the Jumbo Trot on this end of the arena. We're about to take you back to 1998, 23 years ago, to an event called Equitana that was staged in a bluegrass state of Kentucky. Ladies and gentlemen, all eyes on the Jumbotron, please.
Thank you.
horse. It's the son of Gigi Odd's wizard that Paulette Stout is riding tonight. It's a multi-event champion. His name is Botilli. And of course, Botilli's pulling what we call a dray, and it's an original Gypsy Wagon, ladies and gentlemen. And you'll be able to take a close look at it. And of course, Botilli, once again, that son of Gigi Odd's the wizard. Very good temperament, disposition, works well driving and riding as well. And of course, making their way into the arena now, ladies and gentlemen, is an original Gypsy Vardo, being driven by Nikki Qualls and Candace Taylor. You know, Nikki Qualls was born and raised in Texas, but moved to Alaska at 19 years of age, where she worked for the horse-drawn carriage company and learned that she had a passion for draft horses and driving. And while in Alaska, she drove carriages, sleighs, and skidded logs for small projects with Persia rods and mules. After returning to the lower 48, she met Candace Taylor and was introduced to the wonderful Gypsy Vanner horses. Now, Nikki has started young horses driving and remains passionate about teaching both adults and youth about all things driving. When I'm working with horses, Nikki shows Boston Terrier and currently has the number 5 owner-handled Boston Terrier in the United States. Nikki has also been in the veterinarian industry as a technician and hospital practice manager for 30 years. She currently resides in Arkansas with her spouse Hayden and their 5 Bostons, Phoebe, Philip, Chester, Benelli, and Thomas. And of course, meet Candace Taylor. She's the number 2 driver. Candace was born and raised in Georgia, where she currently resides with her husband and 6 children. Candace owns Taylor Farms Gypsy Vanner Horses, where they show, breed, and train and promote the Gypsy Vanner horse. Now, she also operates Georgia Draft Horse Rehabilitation and Recovery, where they focus on rehabilitating draft horses and other working breeds physically, nutritionally, and behaviorally. Now, Candace has also opened her farm to retired Gypsy Vanner horses at the farm, which has included the producer and the late Dazzle Dance. Candace was trained to drive almost 10 years ago by Nikki Qualls, which is where their friendship blossomed at the end of the line. And together they are so honored to be here sharing their passion for driving and the Gypsy Vanner horse with you. Now, the horse being driven is Gigi El Devo, a 14-year-old gelding out of Gigi Birthday Girl and the great Lancho Drop. Devo was bred right here in Ocala by Dennis Thompson of Gypsy Go. Devo is now proudly owned by the lovely Miss Louise Brandon Shane. Devo is an accomplished show horse who is now stepping out of retirement to perform for you here today. He is a power enhanced by pride, a courage heightened by challenge, and his is a swiftness intensified by strength, a majesty magnified by grace. He's a timeless beauty, touched with gentleness and a spirit that calls our hearts to dream. The one and only Gigi El Devo, ladies and gentlemen, along with Nikki Qualls and Candace Taylor, as they set up camp, it's Gigi El Devo from the Vargo. Now, the Vargo is what the gypsies traveled in many, many, many years ago. And of course, inside that wagon, there's a bed, cooking facilities, many times a laboratory or a sink, as many of us would call it. And the gypsy traveled the countries in these wagons, and that's where they made their home. So that was a prequel to what we know today as the motor home. That's an original motor home, okay? Or Winnebago, you might say. Now, gypsies have long been among the most mysterious exotic peoples on Earth. They've been described as a race of nomads who have no real home, and gypsies do have their own language, Romani, and they identify themselves as Romani people. Gypsies came to Europe long ago from India. Now, gypsy history remained unknown for many centuries, largely because they had no written language, and strangely enough, they had forgotten where they came from. The gypsies generally claimed to be Egyptians, hence the name Gypsy. But Europeans eventually discovered that the Romani language is related to certain dialects of India. And from there, Gypsy history was gradually put together. A gypsies were low caste people in India who made their living as wandering musicians and singers. And in the year 430, gypsy musicians, as a matter of fact, 12,000 of them from the tribe of India known as Jat, called Zod by Persians, were given as a gift to the Persian king, Bahram. And in large numbers of them were captured by the Byzantines in Syria, where they were landed as great acrobats and jugglers about 855. Now, gypsies are noted in the 12th century history of Constantinople as bear keepers, snake charmers, fortune tellers, and sellers of magic amulets to ward off the evil eye. Balsamon warned the Greeks to avoid these ventriloquists and wizards that he said were in league with the devil. Now, settled people are usually suspicious of rootless, masterless wanderers with no fixed address. The gypsies traveled about Europe, as did no other people, so they knew more than most about what was happening in various countries and the activities of their inhabitants. This led to rumors that gypsies were being used as spies. Now, there were 133 laws against gypsies that were passed in the Holy Roman Empire between 1551 and 1774. One of those, passed in 1710, made it a crime to be a gypsy woman or an old gypsy man in Germany. They were widely viewed as godless and wicked people. Violators were to be flogged, branded, and deported. And to be a gypsy man in Germany was to be given a life sentence of prison and hard labor. And children of gypsy people were taken away from them and put into good Christian homes. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, how about our little gypsy lady in the lead pony? Yes, indeed. All right. And the dray being pulled by Bojelli. Just doesn't get any better. Let's give them all a big round of applause. And they'll be setting up camp. There you go. Great job, young lady. And I'll tell you what, these gypsies come in different sizes. And we'll talk about those a little later. The gypsy VANNER, that is. Gypsy people do too, as a matter of fact. But we'll be talking about the different sizes of the Gypsy VANNER cob horses and the different breeds that make up the Gypsy VANNER. You know, it's all about immigration. Immigration of these horses to the United States 25 years ago. And tonight, once again, we celebrate that silver anniversary because the first ones came to this great country 25 years ago. And we'll watch Paulette pick up the Romany flag. What does it symbolize? The Roma flag is dark blue on top, representing the heavens. Green below, representing the earth, with 16 red spoke chakras in the middle, in recognition of the Indian origin of Roma. Now, representing movement and the burst of fire from which all creation emerged at the beginning of time. Now, the chakra looks like a red wheel with 16 spokes. It reminds the Roma of their Indian origin. And the wheel in the center of the flag symbolizes the constant movement and progress. Now, the Roma originate from Punjab and Rajasthan, areas of India. And their ancestors immigrated from India approximately 1,000 years ago and traveled all through Asia to Europe and later to the Americas. For centuries, they maintained a nomadic lifestyle, but were forced to settle under the communist regimes of Eastern Europe.
Thank you.
of the United Kingdom. Now, we're going to take place next to the Gypsy Vardo, and I'm going to explain to you what breeds created the Gypsy Banner. And, of course, we'll begin, ladies and gentlemen, with the largest horse out there at this point, and, of course, none other than that of the Clydesdale, ladies and gentlemen. All right, you see it going in front of you right now at this point. The Clydesdale, you know, they weigh anywhere from 1,600 to 2,400 pounds. They're 16 hands high to 18 hands high. That's 64 inches to 72 inches. Their body is long. They have silky feathering on their legs, round feet, broad forehead, arched and long neck. And best for riders and owners of all levels. If you've ever seen a horse-drawn Budweiser parade, you've probably marveled at the majestic steeds, one of the most recognizable heavy horse breeds. They're typically very gentle, easygoing, and trainable horses that can be a joy to work with. The Clydesdale were developed in Scotland during the late 18th and early 19th centuries. In the late 1800s, the regal horses were introduced in the United States, and it's where they were used to plow fields, power machinery, pull wagons, and perform other tasks that require their formidable strength and endurance. And of course, I guess the next horse would be that of the Shire breed, ladies and gentlemen. It's the white horse that you see on the arena floor this time. You know, the Shires, they weigh anywhere from 1,800 to 2,400 pounds, run 16 hands to 18 hands as well, like the Clydesdale. Very tall, muscular build, large hooves, feathering on the legs, long arch neck, slightly Roman nose. That's where you'll see an arch in the nose of the animal, and they're best for all levels of riders and owners as well. And of course, the magnificent and rare Shire horse is best known for its height and strength, holding records for being the tallest horse in the world. But in spite of their imposing size, Shire horses are typically calm, docile, and eager to please, and be good for horse lovers of any experience level. Shire horses are named for the British Shires countryside where the breed was developed. The Shire horses came to the United States around 1853. In the days before machinery became the workhorse of the agriculture and industry, well, the Shire horse was used for its immense pulling power. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for our white Shire on the arena floor? And of course, we talk about the Friesian. Friesians are black horses in color normally, 1,300 pounds on average, 14.2 to 17 hands high, heavy, sturdy stature with a high arch neck and a thick mane and tail. They're used for sport, show, and family purposes. Friesian horses originate in the Netherlands and Germany, and they're graceful and nimble horses that are typically used for recreation, while their athletic Friesian sport horse relatives are often used for competitions and performances. The breed is also sought out for recreational purposes by individuals, especially trail riders. They're gentle and careful enough to accommodate riders of all ages. All right, let's talk about the Dale Pony. These are very hardy ponies, usually 14 hands to 14.2 hands high. Colors are predominantly black with some brown, bay gray, and rarely chrome. White markings are allowed as a star in her snip, and white hind fetlocks, and ponies display they're downgraded to Section B. Now, Dale's ponies are renowned for the quality of their hard, well-shaped feet and legs, which should display beautiful dense flat bone, and their action is straight, high, and true, and they're good movers, really using their knees and hocks for a powerful drive. How about a hand for the Dale Pony, huh? Then we talk about the Fell Pony. And of course, it's another pony breed that helped make up the Gypsy Banner. They're 13.2 hands to 14 hands. That's usually pretty acceptable. Typically, they weigh between 350 and 450 kilograms. So if you want to figure pounds, it's too. Acceptable colors are black, brown, bay, or gray, but not chestnut, piebald, or skewbald. Some have a small star on their forehead and a small amount of white on their hind feet. All right, how about a hand for the Fell Pony? All right, pretty much best for owners and riders of all levels. All right, I want to tell you about LBSS, the Cabbage Cob. You see on the arena floor now by the Vardo. It's a 5-year-old mini Gypsy Cob mare. She's being led by Anna Marie Bright, Adina Michelle of Bluewater Horse Ranch out of Sparks, Florida. And of course, she's a 12.2 hand baying color that's trained to drive and ride. She's currently in foal to MHB Stokes Tiny Tim, which you'll see under the card. It's the smallest mini Gypsy here this evening, owned by Stephanie Christensen. She was bred by Tasha Meyerly of Lazy Bee Stallions Station out of Brooksville, Florida. Now, we talk about these animals being warm blood animals. Well, there's a little cold blood in them as well. That being of the American paint horse. The American paint horse is a cold-blooded animal, and it's coming around the rear of the arena now. And of course, a cream-colored paint this is. We'll get it more in line with your eyesight there. Very popular breed thanks to its flashy coloring. Its temperament and versatility. You know, paint horses can suit riders and owners of all experience levels. They excel in various equestrian sports, as working horses and as solid general riding horses. In the 1500s, the Spanish explorers brought the predecessors of the paint horse breed to North America. These horses likely had Barb, Andalusian, and Arabian bloodlines and sported distinctive spotted and two-tone coloring. In fact, many experts believe the explorer Hernando Cortez brought a particular sorrel and white stallion to North America from which the modern paint breed might be descended. Ladies and gentlemen, all of those helped to make up the Gypsy Vanner breed. How about a hand for your time? Okay, and the smallest pony you see on the arena floor, I'll tell you what, they just don't get any cuter, do they? Yeah, they run from the grands to the classics to the minis, and this is a mini, if you see on the arena floor. The grands are the ones such as Crystal Lion Strider that she's been riding. The classics are much like Oz, or maybe just a little smaller, and the minis are like what you see on the arena floor at this time. So once again, let's give them all a big round of applause. All of the horses and women to making us the Gypsy Vanner family.
Champion Tandem. tandem driving team in North America, and that's before anybody really competed horses at all. And they also had, the two horses they had were Jasmine and Esmeralda. Esmeralda is the mother to this black horse that I am riding now. These two have no experience doing this, so he's in a training surcingle, and he's just a young four-year-old, just turned four in July. And so I just started them. They are going to be a tandem driving team. They will be reliable. Don't clap, whatever you do. They will be reliable. They've got really super duper dispositions, but all of this stuff will make them be a little bit tough to deal with. Willie here, he's actually helped his owner, Leslie Davis, win her bronze medal in Western Dressage. So again, sometimes you can't get them to do exactly what you want in this sort of an environment, but there is videos, believe it or not, of them driving. So anyway, as I ease them out, don't clap, thank you, Joanne and Bill, for coming for this. This yes. is in your honor. As long as I get out without getting killed. There you go. Don't clap yet.
All right, young horses, can I have to be worried with the noise
Grabby.
Being made? So she can keep them under control. That's what we call riding tandem, being horseback.
Oh, okay, now horse you can beast. Clap. Let's start with one more bubble.
All right, we're going to talk about another lady that was pictured on the Jumbotron. That was Jackie Clark. And of course, she's known for Lashes Lessons. It's a book series, an elementary substance abuse prevention and character development curriculum, was created by educator and author Jackie Clark. Jackie's an avid writer, loves the world of children and creativity. And of course, growing up in a family of readers, Jackie spent many days of her childhood visiting the local library, and evenings spent with her family. In her home was filled with books, popcorn, and imaginary adventures. And as an elementary teacher, Jackie enjoyed developing the love of books in her students. Next, we'll talk about Sue Rathbone. How many of you have seen the movie The Greeting of Whitney Brown, huh? Or heard about the world-renowned horse Odd Job Bob that was featured in that movie? And of course, Sue was featured in the pictures there on the Jumbotron.
You can check out my awesome co-star. His name's Bob, and he's running around somewhere. He's an awesome Gypsy Vanner, and it was really cool to be able to work with him because I never even ridden a horse before the movie. So it was very awesome to be able to work with horses, and I actually got my own Gypsy Vanner at the end of the movie, so that was even cooler. I hope you have fun watching these awesome scenes, and I know that we had a lot of fun filming the movie, so check them out. Oh yeah, and make sure to visit us on facebook.com/thegreening. Okay, bye guys.
And tonight we want to remember Kayla Peterson. She was known for giving the Vincent Spotlight Gilding Award at Rescue Memorial each year. She did this for 16 years, and we lost her this year, secondary to COVID-19. And of course, her family continues to give that award in her memory. So tonight we dedicate this as well to Kayla Peterson. And then Lynn Strowman owns the Gypsy Rose Ranch. Lynn was the first one to have a ranch on the West Coast. And, well, it depends on how you look at it. It can be a Bodie, B-O-D-I, or Bodie mare. Now, let me tell you a little story about that. When they were buying this horse from the Gypsies, they said, what's the horse's name? They said, Bodie. Bodie? Said, what do you mean, Bodie? They said, we've never heard of a horse named Bodie. He said, no, the horse has a beautiful body. And that's where they got the name Bodie. But anyway, if they're here, Lynn Strawman and family, if you would, please stand on this end. Thank you, Lynn. We appreciate you there. Marcia Sapp, we're ready for you. Marcia is owner and a head trainer for Southern Oaks Equestrian Center in Tallahassee. She is without question a respected horsewoman in both Florida and nationally. Her list of accomplishments spanning the last 2 decades is very remarkable, to say the least. Her work focuses on complete equestrian education, which is a combined effort, that is, to train the horse and the rider in unison. Marsha's work in the extreme Mustang makeover has found her placing among the top 5 3 different times. A very, very tough competition held mainly in Fort Worth, Texas. She's been the president of the Southern Hunter Jumper Association, president for the South when eventing and dressage association, is a current coach for the FSU equestrian team since 2004. Once again, Marsha Sapp and Gigi Vanner. Marsha?
Thank you.
need both English riders and Western riders. The Western being like Crystal, our own Strider, sporting a Western saddle, okay? And then you see the English like Paulette had on ours, riding an English saddle. Let me ask you, how many Western fans do we have tonight, huh? The Western riding fans. Come on, make the noise if you want to.
Sabrina now, as Sabrina takes the Western mount through. All right. Maybe a side pass through the poles, huh? All right. How about it, Western fans? Look at there. I think she upped one, didn't she, huh, Western? Okay. The next obstacle on the course is going to be across the waters. Across the waters. Now, Sabrina will cross the waters first. Sabrina. Now, you'll watch it by the platform there. Sabrina being the Western rider. There you go. Look at there. Crossing the waters. How about a round of applause for our Western fans, huh? Okay. And now Courtney will cross the waters. All right. Yeah, go ahead. There you go, Sabrina. Get your people up. Yeah. Yeah, cheer them on. There we go. Oh, look at that. Just jumped the waters. Not bad. Job well done, Courtney. Okay. Now we see the two barrels set up on the arena floor, and there's a board across them. We call it barrels with a board. Now, Courtney? We're going to go with you first on this one. What can you do with the two barrels and the board situated across them? Let's see you go to work. Here's the English. All right. Bringing the pony around. Once again, it's Hunter versus Western. Here we go with the Hunter mount. Hey, check it out. What do you think? All right. How many of you Western fans think that Sabrina can up that one, huh? All right. Watch Sabrina go to work with a board across the barrels. Oh, wait a minute. She's going to treat it as a gate, huh? She's smart. She's going to open the gate and then go through. Yeah, what do you think, Western fans, huh? Working the gate from horseback. No jumping on that one. Well, it's very unusual to see a Gypsy Vanner jump anyhow. Okay, the wide jump. Courtney, let's go to work on the wide jump. Once again, very few of the Gypsy Vanners are jumping animals. I want you to look at the muscles on this animal. 9-year-old pony that she's been riding for quite some time, all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. Hey, there you go. Yeah. All right, Sabrina, you're going to have to up that one. What are you going to do, huh? All right, come on. That's it, huh? Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've just witnessed it. How about a round of applause for Courtney Alexander and Picasso and Sabrina Lee and Great Scott, English versus Western. All right, we're going to clear the arena, and then we're going to bring more of the carts back to you. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll soon be meeting Tasha Byerly and company, many gypsies. And, of course, we'll tell you more about that in just a moment once we get the arena clear. And, hey, how about a hand for our arena workers? I'll tell you what, pride in their effort is usually their only reward. That was our rap dancers, too, right? All right. I take back what I said about you earlier, ladies. Huh? You do a great job. Well, let me ask you thus far, have you enjoyed the show of what you've seen? All right, we've got some neat things to come. Yes, indeed. More freestyle to come. We're going to talk about the youth. And, of course, we're going to see Oz one more time. And we've got a special treat by a group of five young ladies that will be bringing us down to the end. Something that very few of you have ever seen. All right, we're ready for the mini gypsies looking for Tasha Byerly and company.
Wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star. Come out, wherever you are. The young lady who fell from a star.
Thank you.
Yes, indeed. I'll tell you what, it takes me back to my childhood, too, you know. All right, how about a round of applause for all of those, huh? And, of course, LBSS, the Cabbage Cob, is a five-year-old mini gypsy cob mare being led by Anna Marie Wright and Adina Michelle, the Blue Water Horse Ranch out of Parks, Georgia. 12.2 hand bay and color, trained to drive and ride. Currently at full. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, let these youngsters and ladies and gentlemen know what you thought of them here tonight, huh? All right, let's talk about the wizard and the Garocha pole.
Oh, Miss Elphaba, many years I have waited for a gift like yours to appear. Why, I predict the wizard could make you his magic grand vizier. Write at once to the wizard. Tell him of you in advance. With a talent like yours, dear, there is a definite chance if you work as you should. You'll be making good.
Did that really just happen? Have I actually understood this weird quirk I tried to suppress or hide is a talent that could help me meet the wizard if I make good. So I'll make once I prove my worth, and then I meet the wizard, what I've waited for since birth. And with all his wizard wisdom, by my looks he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb, or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl on whom I can rely. And that's how we'll begin, the wizard and I. Once I'm with the wizard, my whole life will change. 'Cause once you're with the wizard, no one thinks you're strange. No father is not proud of you, no sister acts ashamed, and all of us have to love you when by the wizard you're acclaimed. And this gift or this curse I have inside, maybe at last I'll know why. When we are hand in hand, the wizard and I, one day he'll say to me, Elphaba, girl who is so superior, shouldn't the girl who's so good inside have a matching exterior? And since folks here to an absurd degree seem fixated on your verdigris, would it be all right by you if I degreen, if I you? Of course that's not important to me. All right, why not? Just had a vision almost like a prophecy. I know it sounds truly crazy and true, the vision. vision's hazy, but I swear someday there'll be a celebration throughout Oz. That's all to do with me.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, Paulette and Madame Morville. All right. It just doesn't get any better, does it, ladies and gentlemen? I'll tell you, I am really amazed at all the talent here this evening. And, of course, let's talk about the youth. They're the future of this breed. You know, they've only been here 25 years. And, ladies and gentlemen, if we are to ensure another great 25 years, we need to get our youth involved with the Gypsy Vanner Cob Horses. And, of course, you can do your part by bringing them to more shows, helping them research a little more about them. You can go to the Gypsy Vanner Cob Foundation to learn more about that as well. And, of course, right now, I'd like to make welcome Gigi Vanner and, of course, a little musical dressage. Rider Henley.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, once again, how about a round of applause for Henry and Gigi Vanner? A little dressage musical. All right, we're going to clear the arena, and I'll tell you what, we've got a special treat coming up. Again, many of you have never seen what you're about to witness on this arena floor, and I, for one, just marvel at the young ladies you're about to meet. And, of course, ladies and gentlemen, you're about to meet five young ladies, and they're members of Deep or Down South Performing Arts, I should say. And, of course, they're going to be doing what we call vaulting. Now, what is vaulting? It's the art of dance and gymnastics on the back of a moving horse. So, ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome five young ladies, Kaylee Edgerton, as well as Alejandra Torres, Cadence Ray, Jocelyn Edgerton, and Sadie Taylor, as they get ready to make their way into the arena. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a big, warm Ocala welcome, if you would, huh? Watch these young ladies as they make their entrance in. And, of course, you see what they're being led out with, a vaulting horse. And, of course, they'll work from the back of that horse in just a moment. Now, I want you to look. Stair steps as far as the young ladies are concerned. Look at here. What do you think? All right. All right. Alejandra. Torres. Look at there. Working a few of the gymnastics. Okay. That's just part of the job that they'll be doing. Great job there, young lady. Yes, indeed. Hey, no stop to her, huh? All right. Give her a round of applause. Make welcome Cadence Ray. Ah, look at there. All right, Cadence. There's Jocelyn. Okay. Or better yet, Sadie Taylor, that is. 6 years old. Hey, how about it? Okay, we're going to bring them into the arena along with the horse that they're going to be vaulting from. Now, once again, it's the art of dance and gymnastics on the back of a moving horse. Now, what you saw them do on the arena floor, they're going to do some of it on the back of that horse as well. Now, the vaulters, they'll line up, and then we'll get the horse lunging in a full circle on the arena floor. And then we're going to see them go to work one at a time. Okay, there you are. Let me introduce you. Thank you, ladies. Let me introduce you to your first vaulter. It's going to be Kaylee Edgerton. All right, they're taking their positions. Kaylee Edgerton, 19 years old, grew up with horses in northern Georgia, beginning her riding career at the age of 10. She's a member of the Edgerton family, long well known in the state of Georgia for their work and love of draft horses. Kaylee and the family, they've shown their horses in Western Pleasure, Saddle Seat, Hunt Seat, Halter, and Driving. And in 2015, Kaylee, alongside her mother, Brittany, brought their love for drafts into the vaulting world. In 2021, Kaylee is excited to share her love for our extra-large four-legged friends with those who have a passion for horses, music, gymnastics, and fun. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome Kaylee Edgerton.
I've learned you let your guard down when somebody's good for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for Kaylee Edgerton, huh? Okay, meet Alejandra Torres. Alejandra is a 15 years old, been a competitive vaulter for 6 years. She's won many blue ribbons in a more challenging part of competitive vaulting, known as the compulsory test. Now, Alejandra has been riding horses since she was very young and had much success in showing draft horses and barrel racing. Alejandra is a very accomplished dancer, cheerleader, and aerialist as well. Once again, Alejandra Torres. Job well done, Alejandra. Now, let me mention, the horse that they're using is Delilah. Delilah's a green vaulting horse. Her liver literally just started doing this, so we'll do all we can to make this a very professional demonstration. But we'll have to prioritize the kid's safety if anything unforeseen should occur. Please make welcome Cadence Ray, 8 years of age. She's been vaulting since she was five. Cadence enjoys gymnastics, tumbling, silks, body contortion, riding horses, barrel racing, and pretty much anything else involving horses. Cadence also loves spending time with her family, and she dreams of one day performing in a circle. Ladies and gentlemen, 8-year-old Cadence Ray. All right, ladies and gentlemen, watch her as she goes to work. And, of course, she can hear you. And I'll tell you what, you've been a great audience tonight. And remember, they can get all the ribbons and money and buckles forever. But it's your applause that really means the world to these kids. That applause will long be remembered, huh? Okay. I want you to meet Jocelyn Edgerton. Jocelyn. She's 8 years old, grown up with horses her whole life. Jocelyn started vaulting at the age of three. Now, just 8 years old, Jocelyn is already an accomplished competitive vaulter, gymnast, aerialist, and she even shows horses under saddle. Jocelyn turns 9 in a couple of weeks. Ladies and gentlemen, 8-year-old Jocelyn Edgerton.
This is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. And buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what can gather. Your fever dream, can't you see you getting closer? Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flying open. It's a picture in the pulpit and your blind devotion. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall, it's holding all that you know. So tell me, do you want?
Give it up for 8-year-old Jocelyn Edgerton. All right, the youngest of the crew is 6-year-old Sadie Taylor. She began vaulting at the age of 4. She's been raised with horses her whole life, most of which have been draft horses. And she currently trains in riding, vaulting, and driving. She has a special place in her heart for senior horses and those with disabilities as well. Sadie loves makeup, art, and dancing. And she's very excited for the opportunity to perform for all of you here this evening. 6-year-old Sadie Taylor.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine.
All right, give it up for Sadie Taylor. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Down South Performing Arts, Kaylee Edgerton, Alejandra Torres, Kaden Gray, Jocelyn Edgerton, and Sadie Taylor. Let's give them a big collective round of applause. Thank you, ladies. And, of course, let's not forget the old trusty mount there, Green Horse, at doing this once again. I'll tell you what. If it weren't for the disposition of these animals, yes, these girls wouldn't come to trust them as they have. Huh? Thank you, Delilah, the trusty man. Okay. All right, once again. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you've met Crystal Lyons. Let me ask you tonight, how many of you enjoyed Crystal's music and singing and her talents in comedy as well? Well, we're going to bring Crystal back out. And, of course, people can enter the arena as she sings the final song here tonight. And she'll be selling CDs and selling her books, Cowgirl Logic, as you make your way out of the arena tonight. But she wants to meet each and every one of you. But you can come down. You can meet the people on horseback. Just be careful with the animals. And I do want to thank you for being here, for being such a great audience. Mm-hmm. We hope you've enjoyed the show. Let me ask you, how many of you have enjoyed the show
at
the Gypsy Vanner Horses, huh? All right. Thank you to Paul Ed Stout and the Gypsy Vanner Cobb Horse group. We appreciate them as well. All right, Crystal, it's all yours. I'm Joe Dumas. God bless you. We'll see you down the road.
Thank y'all so much. My boys went to a tiny school, 20-some-odd students from first grade on to 12th. The whole school, 20-some-odd students. So they asked me to write a song for graduation one day. And as small things go, small schools and stuff, they asked me about an hour before graduation. And I didn't have anything that fit. And I thought, I'm just going to write a song. And that usually ends up really bad. And when 10 minutes, I had this song about make a difference in life as you go. But it's not just about kids graduating. And my son goes off into the Army and all of that. And it's about us as we go through life. Let's make a difference. Let's don't leave things just... Let's make a difference. So I hope you enjoy the song. The song's special to me. It's called As You Go. Go ahead. Y'all have been great. You really have been great. As you go, be who the Lord called you to be. Don't expend your life in mediocrity. Fulfill your destiny as you go. And as you go, hold to the things you know are true. Never compromise what you know to do. Other lives depend on you. As you go, and as you go, lift your sails and catch the wind. Set your heart and don't give in. No matter what prevailing winds may blow, as you go, and as you go, hold strong through the joy and through the pain. Live such a life as to bring honor to His name. Don't leave this world the same. As you go, and as you go, lift your sails to catch the wind. Set your heart and don't give in. No matter what prevailing winds may blow, as you go, lift your sails to catch the wind. Set your heart and don't give in. No matter what prevailing winds may blow, as you go. As you go. Lord be with you. Our heart goes with you. Thank y'all so much. You've been so, so kind and patient. I think they're going to invite y'all to come on down, right?
Yeah, come on down. Look at
come
the
on down. Meet the people. Meet the horses. Who gives a rip about the people? Meet the horses. Come on. There's a gate down there. You can come or down on here, and you can come on in the arena.
And you can move those barriers so they can get in easier.
Yeah. And God bless y'all. And it's been so nice to come to Florida. Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you. Y'all are so cool.